Hi friends, welcome to Cool Ketchup. Today we are going to see pumpkin seed halwa. Before that, if you are new to my channel, please do subscribe my channel and turn on the bell notification so that you'll get my regular updates. We are going to see pumpkin seed halwa. It is a very good and healthy recipe. We should know the nutrient value of each and every recipe what we are cooking at home. Let me explain you the health benefits and the nutrient value what it has. Come, let's see the recipe now. Now I have taken pumpkin seed. You can see it will be like this. It is be green in color. It is very healthy actually. I'll tell you the benefits, what all benefits are there with this pumpkin seed. See here, you can see it will be green in color. It is available in markets. You'll get everywhere in the market, like dry fruit shops you'll get it, like cucumber seeds and pumpkin seeds, everything is available in market. See here, I have taken 1 cup of this pumpkin seed, and the same cup I have taken 1.5 cup of sugar. I have taken you can even try with jaggery powder if you want. Then I have taken around 5 to 6 tablespoon, that is around 100 ml of ghee, homemade ghee we are going to use it. Then rice flour, which we use for idiyappam, that rice flour, it is available in market as well. We are just going to take 1 tablespoon for cleaning that seeds, outer coating of that seed, we are going to clean it. For that purpose, we are going to use this rice flour. Then around 100 to 150 ml of boiled milk. For grinding, we are going to use milk. Milk is optional. If you want milk, you can add. It will be more tasty and it will be healthy. Other than that, you can add even water instead of milk if you don't want. Now we are going to clean the seeds. For that, I am going to take this pumpkin seed inside a bowl. Now with this pumpkin seed, I have sprinkled a little water. See, you can see this much wet it is. Now I am going to add rice flour. Just this much will be fine. If you want, you can add a little more. We are just going to mix like this. We have to keep mixing it for 5 minutes so that green color coating of the seed will come out. If you want, you can sprinkle some more water. Now you can see here, while doing like this, this coating of that seed will come out. See, you can see here, it will be like this. So you can leave it for just 5 minutes. Then if you do like this, all this green color skin will come out. Then we can use it for soaking. Now let us leave it for 5 minutes aside. See, now after 5 minutes, you can start squeezing it. Actually, this rice powder, it acts like a scrubber to remove the green color coating. See here, if you do like this, you'll get that white seed like this. So you have to do with all the seeds, it should come out completely. But there's no harm if you do it like without removing also. One or two, if it is not coming, it is okay. But try to remove the maximum of seeds, it has to be peeled off. See here, while mixing like this, everything is coming out, the green color coating is coming out. Now you can see it, I have removed all the skin. By if you keep on do it like this, that rice flour will act like a scrubber which will peel off that green skin. Now I have removed everything by doing like this. You can rub even with both the hands. Now we are going to wash this with water twice or thrice. See, you can see here, let me wash 2 to 3 times so that it will completely clean off. You have to wash for 2 to 3 times now. Now after washing, see, you can see the white color. It is not necessary that you have to clean completely, but try to clean to the maximum. You can see the color now. See, it will be like this. So it will be like this. You can clean it. You have to soak for 5 to 10 minutes, then only it will come out nicely. While cleaning, you have to keep rubbing like this, so that rice flour will act like a scrubber and it will peel off all the green color skin. And you have to wash it around 4 to 5 times so that it will be completely cleaned. Now we are going to add 1 glass of water and we are going to soak it for around 20 minutes now. Let it soak for 20 minutes. Now after 20 to 30 minutes of soaking, you can see the seeds here. It will become little soft now for grinding. So now let us grind after straining this water. Now after straining the water, I am adding the seeds to the jar now. Actually, it will be little raw compared to other alvas. It has its own nature. It will be little coarse in nature. Even though if you soak for long time, the texture will be little coarse. Now I am going to add 100 ml of milk. You can add little more also. If you add more milk, it is nothing but it will take little more time for preparing this alva. So you can add 100 to 150 ml of milk for grinding the seeds. Let us grind the seed now into a coarse paste, not into a fine paste, into a coarse paste. Now our batter is ready. It should not be a fine paste, it should be little coarse in nature. You can add even a little more milk if you want, like around 50 ml you can add extra also. But if you add more milk, it will take more time for preparing this alva. Actually, this pumpkin seed, like any other alva, it should be in a batter form. See, it should be like a dosa batter consistency after adding even milk. It should not be very watery or it should not be very thick. So this is the consistency now. Come, let's get started with the recipe now. Now I have taken a non-stick pan. We are going to add around 1 tablespoon of oil. We are going to salt this batter. Actually, for other alvas, no need to salt, because this pumpkin seed has a nature like it dominates the raw smell. It will be there even though if you cook for a long time. So to avoid that raw smell, we are going to salt for a minute. Then we can add the sugar. Now let us add the pumpkin seed paste now. Now we are going to salt this paste for around 2 to 3 minutes. That raw smell has to go. Otherwise it will be dominating. Even though if you cook, the raw smell will be there. To avoid that, we are going to salt for around 2 to 3 minutes. Actually, this pumpkin seed, it is very good for health actually. It is rich in protein, fiber, and it is very helpful to reduce the cholesterol level, as it has good cholesterol, and it is also useful for healthy weight loss. So it has many health benefits. So you can give this to your family members. In case if you doesn't want to add sugar, milk, etc., you can even dry roast these seeds with little ghee, or if you don't want to add or eat with this alva, because even sugar is added, ghee is also added. If you are very health conscious, you can have it even like dry roasted. You can roast those pumpkin seeds with little pepper or any other seasoning, whatever you want, with little salt and pepper. You can have that seed as well. It is very good to have daily. If you don't want to add or eat with this alva, because even sugar is added, ghee is also added. If you are very health conscious, you can have it even like dry roasted. You can roast those pumpkin seeds with little pepper or any other seasoning, whatever you want, with little salt and pepper. You can have that seed as well. It is very good to have daily. See, now it is little thick now. Now we can add the sugar. You can add the sugar now. Now we have added that 1.5 cup of sugar. Actually, it is good, as it improves the immunity, it boosts the immunity level. It helps to reduce the kidney stones also. It improves our prostate health. So it is very good for our health actually. I don't know, many of us doesn't know about this seed alva. It is very healthy. It is actually taken from the raw pumpkin actually, that green, when it is green, that time they take out the seed. Normally children's, they have it as a podi, that is chutney powder. They take the matured pumpkin seeds, they will just roast it and they'll grind it into a mixer jar and give it to children as a chutney powder, which they will have it for idli and chutney with ghee or sesame oil. That also tastes good. Otherwise you can give it in this form like alva. It is very healthy and it is easy like other alva. So you can try this recipe. See here, now the sugar started melted. It has become little watery now. See, like this you have to slowly stir it. You have to add little by little oil. Whenever it is sticking on the sides, you can add little ghee to it so that it will not be sticky. For any halwa, you should be very careful and you have to keep stirring, because otherwise that lumps will be formed. It will become very crunchy. So slowly you have to stir it. Like any other halwa, we are not going to add any nuts, I mean roasted cashews or any other nuts, because this nut itself, the seed itself has its own taste which has to be dominating. So I am not going to add any powder, I mean elachi powder or cashew for taste. Now we are going to add little ghee so that it will not be sticking. See here, it has started rolling, so we should be very careful. Always keep in a medium flame so that it will not become little crunchy on the sides. Now we are going to add little more ghee so that it will not stick on its sides. See here, you can see it is not sticking actually, it has started rolling. So once, when you get that mixture moving from one side to other like a ball, that time we have to switch off the flame. So we should be very careful. You should not cook for long time. Then it will be a little crunchy and it will not get the halwa flavor, texture actually. Now we are transferring to a plate greased with ghee. See, now our pumpkin halwa is ready. I have not added any food color for this because food color is not healthy. For that I have not added. If you want, you can add any food color to it. If not, even saffron strands you can add it. Now I have transferred to a plate because we have to stop cooking of that pumpkin halwa. For that I am not see, don't keep it on the same pan, in whichever pan you are cooking the halwa, because we have to stop that cooking. For that immediately you have to transfer to any other plate or bowl, so that heat should not be there. Otherwise it will cook for another 1 or 2 minutes and the texture will change. For that we have to transfer immediately to another plate. Now let it cool for 5-10 minutes, then you can transfer to any bowl or container for storing it. See here, I have not added any cashews or badam for seasoning because pumpkin seed itself, it has good health benefits. So no need to add, because we need the pumpkin flavor. So if you add any other cardamom powder or anything else, the flavor will change. For that I have not added. So it is very rich in protein, fiber, and it helps to reduce kidney stones. It improves prostate health. So it is very healthy. So please try this recipe and leave your comment in the comment box. Now our tasty halwa is ready to serve.
I hope you like this recipe. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please do like, share and leave your comment in the comment box. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you. Thanks for watching.